Hello, welcome to this video. In this quick one, I'm going to show you how you can customize your terminal using a script called Oh-My-Posh. Oh-My-Posh allows you to customize the look of your terminal. You can create your own custom themes, but it comes with a whole lot of themes by default out the gate. Those themes are available in GitHub. It also allows you the ability to install nerd fonts as well, if you're familiar with that at all. And even if you're not, it's just a nice little website where you can see different styles of different fonts, and Oh-My-Posh has the ability to install these nerd fonts from the command line. So let's go ahead and get started by clicking getting started. Here it's available for a number of different operating systems. I'm going to click on Linux using mine in Ubuntu underneath WSL. Side note, with WSL, since it runs on Windows, you could just use the installer for Windows, and that way you'd have Oh-My-Posh at your Windows level, as well as available in your subsystem for Linux. All right, so sticking with the Linux option, I can do manual or homebrew in that case. I'm gonna stick with manual. And I'm gonna try this first command over here. This is going to download the install script, and it's going to install it in the user local bin. If I hit enter, I'm going to get an issue or an error here. This could be permissions based, as it could not write to it. So what I can do is then use this alternative command here. What I need to do is create a directory, because I'm going to say, hey, install it in this directory. So I'm going to make a directory called bin. And then we're going to grab that second command, which is the same one that's being echoed out here. All right, so now it's being downloaded to my bin directory, and now Oh-My-Posh is installed. Now what I need to do is I need to download one of the nerd fonts, so I can do... And actually, before I do that, I need to add the bin directory to my path, because it's not there, my bin directory I just created. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new file in my home directory called bash_profile. I'm going to hit enter. I'm going to type in export home Ubuntu. Oh, sorry. Export path. We're going to do export path equals $path, colon, and then home Ubuntu bin. And then I'm going to save my work. And then if I type in, actually, I need to execute my bash_profile now. And now if I do an echo path, now that bin directory has been appended to the end of my path. Okay. So now I should be able to type in Oh-My-Posh, and using tab to autocomplete, I can confirm it is installed. I can do a --version. And then we can do a font install. Now you're going to get a list of fonts. And once again, those come from nerd fonts. So we can once again come over here, see which font styles that we might like. I like Big Blue Term for some things. So I'll just go ahead and you just use your arrow keys and hit enter when you're ready to download one. I'm going to download another one as well. Another two. I like the Droid as well as the Hack. Oh. Well, didn't mean that one. All right, so now I have my nerd fonts installed. Now coming back to Oh-My-Posh, if I come over here to prompt, this is where you're going to be where you'll have instructions based off the shell. I have bash. They also support other ones such as PowerShell as well as ZCH if you're using a Kali instance. So the simplest way to just see if your terminal can be changed to a theme is copy the command based off the shell you have selected in this tab. And it's going to use an eval statement called Oh-My-Posh. It would do an init bash. Hit enter. And now my prompt has been, or my terminal session has been changed with that theme. In that case, my shell has been changed. In order to exit out of that theming, I can do execute and then my shell type. And once again, it's bash. And now I'm back in that case. And so this is on the fly in that case. Now, if you want to customize your theme, we're going to click on customization over here in Oh My Posh. And I'm going to zoom out just a little bit. And this is going to give you syntax for the command in order to change your theme. The themes are available in GitHub. You can download them to your machine as well. So what I'll do is I'm going to go to the root of the GitHub. And I'm going to clone. I'm going to copy this. I'm going to do git clone. And I'll just call this Posh Themes. All right, so now I have a directory called Posh Themes. If I do ls Posh Themes, and then there's a directory called Themes, there are all the themes that we have in that case. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a quick change directory to Posh Themes, Themes, pwd. I'm going to grab this full path, copy that. Now what I can do is now I can call a theme. I can do it directly on the command line. What I'll do is come down here and find the one once again for my shell. I'm using bash. So I can do that eval again. I'll find that in the history. So after the init bash, I need to do a dash dash config. And then I paste in my directory and then the name of my theme. Now I know there's a theme called space, so I'll do space omp.json, hit enter, and now I have a new theme in that case. So I can do the exact same thing again. There's a theme called bluish, hit enter, and now my theme has changed again. Now the thing though is if I close this session, I'm going to put my terminal back. I'm going to come back into Ubuntu. Notice that I'm back to my regular terminal in that case. So it's not going to save. If you do want it to save, you have to add it to one of those special files in your home directory. But I'm just going to run this again. And notice we can easily come in here and have that theme. So I'm going to execute bash again. I'm going to do a vim.bash profile in here. And actually, let me execute this. Let me go ahead and grab this command here. So I just have it. Let's copy that. So what I can do now is I can add this directly to my .bash_profile. That way it executes every time I start a new session in that case. And what I can do a shortcut of posh, I can say posh theme. Posh theme equals, and then I can just put the name of my theme here. And add a dollar sign of posh theme. There we go. And then I'll come back over to my posh. And if I click on themes, this is going to be the list of all the themes. So you'll be able to see what it looks like. And let's just make this a little bigger here so you can see all the themes, what they look like here. So you can come over here, some really good different, it's way too big. There we go. Some different themes, different styles. And some show a shorthand for the path. Not like, for example, this blue owl. Instead of having a full path, it'll just have like directory and dot, 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 which I think is pretty cool. Then you have these other ones and just all different styles in that case. Just need to find what worked for you, which you can they have these things that are built directly in. So I might do something such as this Craver here. So I'm going to come over here and type in Craver. And again, I'm using this as a variable in that case. Let's do a WQ and then let's do that /.bash profile. Let's see what happened there. I see. I had a dollar sign here where it's just a variable. The dollar sign goes into when I'm actually calling that variable. There we go. So now I'm able to change my theme in that case. So if I close it out and I come back into my terminal, once again, I go into Ubuntu. And now notice my theme is automatically executing in that case. I can change to something such as user share. All right. And that's what it might look like if you go underneath nested directories. And notice it just gives me the share, even though I'm in the directory user share. It depends on your theme of what it will display and look like. But that's an easy way to customize your theme and get some different styling in that case. Again, I can do that execute bash, and then I'll be returned to my normal shell. And if I want to come back in to what I've set up for my Posh theme, I can execute that profile. By default, my dot bash profile will execute anytime I have a session in that case. So that's a quick way of how to customize your theme using Oh My Posh and Nerd fonts. I'll add the links in the description. Hopefully this video was helpful, and have fun customizing your terminal. Take care. Thanks.